Hello friends, my name is Pradyumna and welcome to my channel VMware NSXCloud, where I share step-by-step videos for VMware portfolio products. If you like what I shared in this video, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe because it helps me grow the channel so that I can continue to create quality content for you. So far in this series, I have covered till shared storage for our nested DC. Now it's time we install vCenter for centralized management. As per VMware, vCenter server provides centralized management of vSphere virtual infrastructure. IT administrator can ensure security and availability, simplify day-to-day tasks, and reduce the complexity of managing virtual infrastructure. It's quite detailed. However, what I would say is, it's the most used UI by a VMware administrator. It's time we start getting our hands dirty. In order to install vCenter, we need to download the installer ISO from VMware download portal. Link to download is available in the description. I have already downloaded it, so we can directly mount ISO and open it. In this video, I'm using Windows platform for starting installation. Hence, we will navigate to BCSC UI installer directory, then Win32. From here, we will run install. It will open an installer wizard. As it is our first vCenter, we will choose first option to install, which again will present a step-by-step wizard where we need to provide information such as name of the host where we want to install our vCenter, vCenter name, credentials, etc. Make sure machine on which we ran the installer has connectivity to ESXi hosts. vCenter installation is highly dependent on name resolution and NTP. Hence, make sure these are configured before we start installation. In our case, we configured DNS records in our last video, and we are using domain controller as our NTP. Accept end user license agreement and move to the next screen. Provide the name of ESXi host on which vCenter will be installed. I am installing it on our nested ESXi host, and provide its root credentials. Accept the certificate presented by ESXi host. Once validation is complete, provide vCenter VM name for inventory. This is not the FQDN. And configure root password for the appliance. Please select a strong password or else it won't allow you to move forward with the wizard. Select the deployment size. In my lab, I'm choosing tiny. However, in real world, you will need to choose the size based on your requirement. Select a data store to host our vCenter. Select enable thin disk mode to make sure that we are not occupying all the space in the data store. Now we will configure network settings for our vCenter, and here we provide FQDN for the appliance. vCenter is installed in two stages, and with this, we are ready to complete stage 1. Stage 1 is successfully completed and vCenter appliance is deployed. Click on continue to start stage 2, where we will configure the appliance. Click next, and for time synchronization mode, choose to sync time with NTP servers and provide NTP details. In our case, it's domain controller. Now enable SSH access as well. Choose option 1 to create a new SSO domain and provide a single sign-on domain name. Configure SSO administrator credentials and then move next. Complete the wizard and wait for stage 2 to finish. With completion of stage 2, vCenter deployment is complete. We will now launch web client and log into vCenter using SSO credentials. Here I will conclude this video. Feel free to leave feedback or suggestion in the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe.